Now, at this stage of the retreat, we're all practicing a little bit differently. We all have our own little themes that we're developing, our very wholesome quality that we're developing. And whatever fits best for you, you can do this for yourself. Take what you need from what I say, and 6R the rest, or let go of the rest, and simply relax. Close your eyes and let go of all the tension, if there is any. But usually we can always find a little bit. Whether it's in your body, or it feels more around your brain and your head, or perhaps somewhere in your face. Let go. This is a good time we have together to refresh, renew. If there was major hindrances for you before this moment today, simply let it all go. And smile. At this stage of the retreat, it might be that some people have started sitting for a little bit longer, perhaps maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, maybe 3 hours, some of you perhaps even 4 hours. Remember that the posture is not so important. What matters is that you feel comfortable, especially at the beginning. Being kind to yourself, being good to yourself. Sitting in a chair is very helpful for long sits. It will help you not having so much unnecessary pain. If you want to sit cross-legged for long periods of time, at the beginning, I recommend to really open up your legs, or don't be afraid to move a little bit to adjust. Of course, the less you move, the better it is in the long run. But if after sometime there is pain in the knees, for example, just open up your legs. No big deal. We do not make it a big deal. We simply release some not really necessary pain, and we can keep on meditating. And that is what really matters. Some of you have started to experience and know that the mind does take time to calm down, to settle down. So the longer sits will be more and more appropriate and necessary if we want to go deeper. And as the mind becomes more steady, little by little, the need to move and change or scratch or itch will also start to fade away and calm down simply by meditation. By mental development. As we slowly learn to let go and relax. And wherever you are on your path, you can always start with metta. If you're farther in the jhanas, you can just do a little 5-10 minutes. That will make your mind collected very quickly, very wholesome, very quickly. And that will lead you straight down the road again. And don't forget, this is happy meditation. This is smiling meditation. The more you smile while sitting, but while doing everything that you do, the faster your progress will be. I guarantee. Remember, the more you enjoy this meditation, the more you understand it. The more you align with it. And the more you are integrating the teaching. if there is joy in our meditation, all the chances are that we will be devoted to it. We will enjoy practicing, and it will be easy to integrate, easy to make progress, easy to practice. Whether some strength. stronger, heavier emotions come up and you need to forgive them or forgive yourself or perhaps even ask for forgiveness. Until that block dissolves. And allows more room in your mind, in your heart, for more wholesome states to take its place. Practicing this with dedication, being honest, truthful with ourselves. Using these states to leverage our practice, to develop what the Buddha called samvega. A sense of urgency, being stirred to action in wholesome states, in wanting to do good, to become better, truthfully. Or perhaps you are feeling metta. Using a recollection. Maybe it's a young animal. Maybe it's somewhere that you really find beautiful in nature. Where that feeling of goodness, of happiness, comes up easily. Perhaps for you it's a friend, a teacher. Perhaps for you is the Buddha himself. The Dhamma or the Sangha, perhaps. Perhaps it's an act of generosity that you've done, that you can remember. Or perhaps it was somebody else that did it, and it inspired you. Generosity also simply means helping. Anyone, at any time. Love and compassion in action. Perhaps even recollecting our own virtue. or perhaps even remembering that in this world there are people who practice unconditional love for all living beings, no matter what they do. Which means that for sure you are loved. In the best possible manner. Or however the metta comes to you. Everybody has their little differences. Perhaps you can practice it, like the Buddha mentioned, boundlessly in all directions. Free. Perhaps for you the feeling has gotten fairly calmer, steadier, more subtle, more refined, easier to sustain. And perhaps the mind has started to become very composed, collected, still, more and more. if your mind gets pulled out, ripped out of the meditation, starts wandering, becomes distracted, thinking, whatever the thought is, we can apply the four steps of wise practice, which is first to notice this, to be aware when that happens, and to let go of that distraction, to calm down the tension that comes with it around your head. To relax back into whatever vehicle of awareness, of development you're using, with a smile. Learn to laugh at the mind when it becomes distracted, when it becomes too serious. Just laugh. The monkey mind, jumping from one branch to another, and slowly we'll start spending more time on the ground, and it will start getting closer to us and closer, and then it will stay for longer periods of time. That's okay. This is a gradual process. It doesn't happen all of a sudden. We need to be patient. And to genuinely practice, to genuinely try. All the time, never giving up. Iti piso bhagava araham samma sambuddho vija charana sampanno sugato lokavidu anuttaro puri sadhamma sarati satta deva manusanam buddho bhagavati svakato bhagavata dhammo sanditiko akaliko ehi passiko panayiko pachattam varitabo nyuhiti. Supatipanno bhagavato savakasango Ujjupatipanno bhagavato savakasango Nyayapatipanno bhagavato savakasango Samichipatipanno bhagavato savakasango Yadirang chattari purisa yugani yatta purisa pugala Isa bhagavato savakasango Ahuneyo pahuneyo dakineyo anjalikaraniyo Anuttirang punye kit Tang lo kasati Bhavatu sabha mangalang rakhandu sabha devata Sabha buddhanu bhavena sada suti bhavantu te Bhavatu sabha mangalang rakhandu sabha devata Sabba dhammanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te Bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata Sabba sanghanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu